We've reached the final out. This is the BYU Baseball Postgame Show on the new skin, BYU Sports Network. BYU Postgame Show is brought to you by the BYU Store, official outfitter of BYU fans everywhere. Also by Smith's Food and Drug. Smith's now has grocery pickup and online delivery to save you time. Also by Zions Bank. For banking that helps you game plan for life, Zions Bank is for you. Let's rejoin the voice of the Cougars, Greg Wrubell.
Score tonight here in the series opener from Stockton is Pacific 6 and BYU 3. Final stats brought to you by Deseret News. BYU 3 runs on 5 hits, 2 errors. Pacific 6 runs on 10 hits, no errors. Pacific left 8 on base. BYU left 7 on base. BYU falls after winning 7 of 8 coming into today. Back-to-back losses, having dropped the last game in San Diego and now the first series at Pacific. Tigers go to 15-28 on the year, 5-14 in the WCC, and they won 5 of 7 in the league after opening 0-12 in conference play. BYU falls to 19-25, 11-11 in the West Coast Conference. So for BYU to finish with a .500 record, the Cougs will have to win out as they have 6 games remaining in the season, and they are 6 games under .500. We'll have Mike Littlewood coming up on the new skin, BYU Sports Network.
This is the BYU Baseball Postgame Show. Now back to the voice of the Cougars, Greg Wrubell.
Series opener in Stockton goes to Pacific by a final score of 6-3 tonight. Some BYU individual numbers of note. Mitch McIntyre has his 5-game hit streak and 10-game reached safely streak come to an end as Mitch goes 0-5. Hayden Latham was 2-4 with 2 runs and an RBI, a solo shot in the third for Hayden. Andrew Pintar goes 2-4 with a run and 2 RBI. He had a 2-run shot in the first inning for BYU. Cole Gamble goes 1-3, and those account for the BYU's 5 hits on the night. BYU's head coach Mike Littlewood has made his way from the dugout to the BYU broadcast booth here at Klein Family Field. And Coach Littlewood, a 3-0 lead. Things look good for you early.
Well, that's what our team thought. You know, we got a 3-run lead, and we just kind of sat on it. And you can look at the scoreboard. In the fourth inning, we went silent. I mean, it was crickets from the fourth inning on. And that's the same. It exactly goes along with how our energy was in the dugout. You know, we jump up and then think that we're just going to run away with this thing. But that's a good college baseball team. They're gonna actually try to win games. And so it's frustrating and disappointing to see how we finish this game today.
Pacific has now won 5 of the last 7 WCC games. They've turned it around.
Yeah, I mean, they're playing loose. And, you know, it's honestly just not the toughest lineup we face. But they're scrappy and they put the ball in play. They try to make 2-strike adjustments and just, you know, touch the ball. But the top of their lineup, those guys can hit. They've got 3 or 4 guys, and if like we did tonight, you know, we came up with Gavello had a key at bat, and Nemevent, their 5-hitter, had a key at bat, and we just faced them in wrong situations and didn't make pitches. And it wasn't, you know, I like the Boston Mabius Gavello matchup, but he has a little bit of a tight elbow. We didn't want to, you know, I don't think anything's wrong with him, but it was tight, and I didn't want to leave him in there. And, you know, when a guy says his elbow's a little tight, that's kind of a red flag. So
did you have a sense going to him that he was going to have to try and work something out when he got there? Or was it kind of
No. When he threw his first pitch, his first warm-up pitch, I thought, that's not right. You know, you've seen a guy enough to know that that's not right. His velocity was way down, and he's kind of looking in the dugout like, this isn't right. And Boston's a tough kid. He's not going to pull himself out. And that's when I went to Billy Hayes, the umpire, and said, I just need to talk to him. And he said his elbow was tight.
Now, who knows? You had Boston in to face Gavello, lefty. You have to go to a righty in Tyson, and that becomes the hit that, you know, kind of changes the game right there.
Well, and when I brought in Tyson, we were actually trying to walk him to let Carter Smith get loose fully loose and go in. But hindsight, probably should have gone to Carter right away. It's kind of a tough thing that Carter's one of our main guys, and you know, we're down in the game. And so in hindsight, I probably made the wrong decision not bringing Carter in right there. But we called what's called a stretch 4 fastball in that situation, and which is about 6 inches off the plate. And then the ball was down the middle, and he made us pay for it. And that's baseball.
Took a 4-3 game to a 6-3 contest, and that becomes your final score tonight. But back at it tomorrow night, try to square the series.
Yeah, I would just talk to him about, you know, we had great energy the first 3 innings, and then we just let it go. We need to come tomorrow with that same energy we had and pick up a win, and then hopefully win the series on Saturday.
All right, Mike, we'll see you on the bus. Thank you.
Thanks, Greg.
All right, that's Mike Littlewood. Back to wrap it up on the new skin, BYU Sports Network.
This is the BYU Baseball Postgame Show. Now back to the voice of the Cougars, Greg Wrubell.
All right, the Pacific Tigers take the first game of a three-game set. Final score is 6-3. BYU and Pacific back here tomorrow night for game two. It'll be a 6 o'clock Pacific time first pitch, meaning 7 o'clock in the Mountain Time Zone. And we're back with you for that at that time. So our thanks to the crew tonight. Terry South is our coordinating producer. Noah Richmond is our control board operator. Engineering help from Barry Squires and Sean Fay. And Sean O'Neill is our BYU Radio assistant station manager, also providing help on the broadcast. So for all those folks, my name is Greg Wrubell. My thanks to Tuckett Slade, BYU's baseball operations director, and my color commentary colleague. Thanks as well to Mike Littlewood joining us postgame. So final score is Pacific 6 and BYU 3. In the meantime and in between time, this has been BYU Baseball on the new skin, BYU Sports Network. Good night and so long from Stockton, California.
You have been listening to live coverage of BYU Baseball on the new skin, BYU Sports Network. BYU Baseball is a production of BYU Athletics in association with BYU Broadcasting. Special thanks to BYU President Kevin Worthen, Vice President Keith Vorkink, Athletic Director Tom Homo, and Associate Athletic Director for Corporate Sponsorships, Casey Stauffer. BYU Baseball is an exclusive presentation of the new skin, BYU Sports Network.